Okay, so here we have the Fluval 13.5 nano tank. And this is day four. I went to the valley a few days ago and picked up this tank for a measly $160. And got some water, got a few pieces of rock. And then I got a heater that night. Got some salt water with that. I'm gonna be doing a lot of other things, but of course we know in this business, slower is better. This is my second nano reef tank, officially. I did a 18 gallon years ago that was very successful. But again, this was a long time ago and things have kind of changed. So let me focus in on what we're doing here. If you can see over here, that is the real reef, which is ironic. It's not real reef rock. It's the fake stuff. And I'm just trying that out for the first time. And the other piece behind there actually is the same thing. It had some Aptasia on it, so I actually put these two pieces and a piece in a bucket of water and put some lemon juice in it. And it seems like everything's working out. I just went to the fish store today, locally, and all the water tested out perfect. So just to kind of cruise here, get the light right. Yeah, green star polyps are doing amazing, actually. You can get close here. You look at these guys, and I can't imagine, I mean, that's really long tentacles those guys have. And these zoas kind of came free, and I'm learning that these zoas are kind of like the weed of the zoas. I forgot what species. But anyway, I can control that. Little turbo snail up there. And of course, Frank. Frank is the new addition. Frank, I just got about 30 minutes ago, and I just had a feeling, and I think he did too, and I think he's got a complex going on, because he is the only real invertebrate or any real big thing alive here in the tank besides corals. The next thing I got was the algae or the kelp, the red kelp here. I don't know the name, sorry guys, but that was a freebie, which is gonna grow hopefully if no one eats it and decides to get ideas. Oh, and this frag here, this was something I got, again, last night, down the other valley. And it's a zoa. It just seems like it's not doing quite as, it had to go through a water change and things like that when I was buying it. And this dude over here I just got here in town. It's an SPS or LPS, whatever the hell that means. I know that the soft coral, it's a soft coral, so I'm going to learn the corals. It's been a while. So he'll eventually spread his wings probably tomorrow. I'm going to back up again and kind of see the perspective of what we call reality here. And like I said, the water tested perfect. And yes, I need to level the tank. And again, this is the Fluval 13.5. People call it the Fluval 12. It's 12 gallons with the extra gallon and a half on the side for the filtration section. I'm just amazed at this, the green polyps here. The green star. I mean, I've done these a long time in the past, and I've never seen these really do so well, especially as a frag. So now I'm gonna do just the blue light, and we've got the ET soundtrack in the background. And this light, of course, is not what I'm seeing with my eye. I'm gonna back up a little bit. Kind of get a weird kind of predator view. Interesting. Oh yeah, and that's my background back here. This is a sign that I had made for my 69 Shasta trailer. Back here, if you can see. I don't know if you can see my hands. Oh, there's my hand. That's going to be installed on my trailer that I'm going to do. But I think it's pretty awesome on the back of my tank. Minus the power cords. So there you go. This is version one of my tank. I'm going to give you guys an update probably in a week or two. And I'm really stoked. I really am pleased with and understanding now the whole, I don't know, it's kind of interesting understanding the whole thing without knowing. Just kind of like in the forest, how the balance of trees and plants, nature, ground, animals. I'm just kind of applying that whole concept being a 42-year-old now. So, there's Frankie. All right, here, toodaloo. See ya, Frankie. Ciao for now. Subscribe if you want.